Hey, we're gonna take a walk out to the bee yard today, see what's going on down there. I haven't been out for a couple of days. The last time I was out, I did a knock test, and we had three strong hives a little while ago, but I just did a knock test a little while ago, a couple of days ago, and two of the hives weren't very active. So let's see what's going on down here. Hopefully we got some bees flying, see if they've got any droppings they're making, see what happens. All right, what I'm seeing so far is not very encouraging. Not seeing any activity out of those two hives. I am out of that hive. Do a little knock-knock and see what happens here. That sounds pretty hollow. Doesn't sound good. That doesn't sound good either. Well, that one hive is certainly as ornery as it's ever been. I want to take a look inside here, see how they did on the mountain camp feeder. Hopefully they didn't run out of food. Got plenty of sugar, but I do see dead bees. There's one here. I don't know if the camera's gonna get this. But down in there. That's not looking good at all. So we're gonna just cover it up and check the next one. That hive's no good. That's a goner. Middle hive, not sure on that one yet. We're gonna take a look inside that and see what's going on. I do know that the third hive there, they're still pretty cranky. They've been cranky bees all last year, and we might have to requeen that, do a split. I don't know what we're going to do there, but well, let's check the middle one and see what's going on there. Okay, let's get the cover off of this one and see what we got going on inside there. Dang. They were doing so well throughout the winter. That's not good. Doing so well right up until now. I mean, they've still got sugar left. They're eating sugar. They didn't burn through that. But I see a dead bee on top. I can't really take that top off of there. What the heck have I got to lose? Now, in case you're wondering, it is 60 degrees outside. No sign of a row on her. A lot of honey in there. Not like they ran out of food. Sugar and nectar and pollen on this side. One of the reasons why I'm not really thrilled about feeding sugar, because I don't want sugar and honey. I want honey, not sugar water. They haven't quite figured that out yet. So, any of you beekeepers out there want to tell me what's going on, look at that, that's loaded with honey. But then, I've got some stuff in there, I'm not sure what the heck it is. But we're going to take it back up to the barn. Close her up. Boy, that's discouraging stuff. Okay, let's take it back up. Okay, decided to take a look down in the other hive. My finger's in the way. See what's going on, and that's not looking good. There's a cluster down in there, but I want to see what kind of honey they have left, so I'm going to take a look a little bit closer. Okay, I'm two frames in. And let me get this cracked open here. Show you something interesting here. Because there's a small cluster right there, in addition to the larger cluster, which you'll see in a second here. A lot of bees are going to fall out. Cluster there. Hopefully you can see that. Cluster there. So what I'm interested to see is right about in the center of the frame. I'll mark it, my thumb's up there right now, right about there. Doesn't look normal to me, but then again, I'm not so sure what I'm looking at half the time anyway. So same over here, like down in here. So I'm just gonna take this little twig, stick it down in there. Now, that's not very soft. check these guys over here. It's pretty dense down in there. No, that's bee bread. Let's check down in here. Bee bread. You can see, try to pull some out for you. It's pretty solid stuff, a mixture of honey and nectar. Hopefully you can see that. Okay, so it's not foul brood, so I'm not worried about that. All right, for those of you who are wondering about mountain camp feeders, this is not the one I built in the last video that I had up there about mountain camp feeders, but exact same dimensions, exact same everything. But you might be wondering about sugar and what happens to sugar when it's in the hive. Now it's a giant clump. And it's pretty much solid, especially on the top. Especially on the top where it's absorbed moisture. And that's one of the functions of the sugar in there, in addition to feeding them. Now, I'm not too keen on feeding the bees sugar because I don't want sugar syrup. Like I said earlier, I would much rather have honey. But that's what it looks like. So that's what you got. Right, Graham? All right, there you have it. Winter hive check, two dead hives. I put that one frame of honey back on the outside chance that those bees are in torpor, and I'll post a link to the torpor video that I did earlier, but it doesn't, they could be, because they're still clustered together there. I don't know what's going on below that first super, but we'll check that out later. But if anyone tells you that beekeeping is easy and not heartbreaking, yeah, I'm gonna disagree with that. It's tough. I thought I was gonna come out of winter with three good hives, at least two good hives, but that middle one, that one's a disappointment to me. The smaller one on the north side, that one I figured that might not make it, but there was honey left in there and there's sugar left in there, so don't know what happened there. No chance or no sign of varroa mites. I saw one small hive beetle in there, and if I've seen in 5 years of beekeeping a dozen small hive beetles, I would be surprised. Single varroa mites, I saw some on the boards, maybe a dozen, two dozen at max, three dozen. Which some beekeepers are gonna say, well, if you've got two dozen, you've got three dozen, you got more. Maybe you do, I don't know, but I've never had a problem with varroa mites. It doesn't look like anything's gone wrong inside the hives other than they just gave up the ghost for some reason, and that I won't be able to tell until later on when I get a chance to pull them all apart and see what's down deeper. So, discouraging news, but hey, that's beekeeping for you. Thanks for watching Clean Slate Farm, I really appreciate it. Thumbs up, I'll post some links down below there to the other beekeeping videos, or somewhere around here or there. The other beekeeping videos we have, it is a fun hobby, but it can be heartbreaking, because this was definitely heartbreaking. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.